In this video, I'm going to show you how to create, sell, and market your first ebook to where you can quit your 9-to-5 job and start making infinite passive income every single month. Now, this is how I was able to get off of my job in the very beginning of my business. And I still make money from this ebook today, and I don't even promote it anymore. Now, in this video, I'm going to be talking specifically about ebooks because that's what I did in the very beginning. Me being a knowledgeable person about what I was talking about and helping people learn in that ebook, that made sense to me. But you can use this same method with almost any and every different type of digital product. Now, a lot of people won't watch this video to the end, and that's perfectly fine. This video is going to be super raw and uncut, no crazy graphics and all those things. I'm just going to talk to you as if you were paying me to coach you one-on-one and help you with your business. So if you really want to learn how to create a digital product and not just create any digital product, I'm talking about creating a digital product that is going to sell and how to sell it, stick around to this video. Also, at the end of this video, I'm going to actually show you the actual ebook that I created that generates anywhere from 5 to 6 figures every single month and or year. Now, for all the naysayers, I want you to understand that I use this same method in the beginning that I'm going to teach you, and I was not a viral sensation. Still to this day, I'm not a viral sensation, and my ebooks as well as all of my digital products are actually still generating a lucrative amount of income for myself and my family. So if you're thinking that you have to have a large amount of followers or subscribers, or you need a large email list, or you need a lot of money to get started, that is a big myth and it's entirely untrue. So let's dive into it. Now, first and foremost, and very importantly, the first thing that you're going to want to do is to pick one thing, not a lot of things, not a whole bunch of steps, just one thing that you're super knowledgeable about to talk and teach everybody that can learn something or solve a problem that will help get them from point A to point Z. Now, I'm not saying that you can use this and you can build your whole business off of this. I'm just talking about this digital product. You want to keep it simple, and it's going to be so much easier if you're very knowledgeable about it. And it can be almost anything. It varies from person to person, but anything that you can talk about off the top of your head, or somebody asks you a question about it and you don't have to prepare or write out a script or a presentation. And that one thing you're most knowledgeable about is going to be the topic of your digital product or your ebook. This could be how to create 4-course meals in under 15 minutes. This could be how to change a flat tire. Anything that you're knowledgeable about, people, that's what you want to teach in your digital product. Whatever your topic is going to be that you're most knowledgeable about, start there and use that first. That's going to bring us to step number two. Now, for step number two, we're going to put the actual process of creating the ebook and all those things that goes along with it to the side. What you're going to do at step two is start figuring out how you're going to get people to buy and want to buy that ebook or that digital product. So to make it very plain and simple, while you're actually creating the ebook, the process of selling it starts right then, which is going to bring us to step number three. While you're creating your ebook, while you're putting all the pieces together for your ebook, you're going to start building your audience and building your email list. Now, a lot of you guys are going to be thinking, oh my God, I know he was going to say that. This is going to be a lot of work. This is going to be too hard. I thought it was going to be something simple that I could do right now and start making money as soon as tomorrow. Yes, you could probably make some money as soon as tomorrow if you're that good, but it is highly unlikely that's going to happen. But to be honest with you guys, thinking back when I was actually doing this, and I still do this to this day, it's not actually as hard or as long as you might think it is. Keep in mind, I started doing this when I didn't have a lot of subscribers. I didn't have the knowledge that I have right now, and I didn't have any fan base or raging customers lining up to buy stuff from me. However, my subscribers and my audience started to grow more quickly because I started using these tools I'm about to teach you right now. And one of the things I was doing, I wasn't just trying to build an audience. I was trying to build an audience that cares and actually cares about what I'm selling and would be most interested in buying. And this is going to require you to start creating content and putting it out on social media. Now, there's a lot of social media platforms out there. In the beginning, I started out with TikTok. That was my platform of choice because at that time, I wasn't real good at creating long-form content, nor did I really have the time. But nowadays, you can choose any platform that you want that makes sense with you and your family and your lifestyle. But I want you to understand this. It doesn't matter which one you choose. All of them are fine. Pick one platform and stick to that and become skilled at creating and putting out content on that platform and only that platform. Now, once you choose that platform, then you're going to start putting out content centered around the experience and knowledge of you have with that topic, that thing that you're most knowledgeable about. Whatever your topic is, you're just simply going to start creating content around your experience and your journey of it. Things I learned when I first started creating these meals, the best and worst meals I found that my family hated the most. Whatever it is, you're going to create content around that experience and your journey. Now, just to give you guys some background, one of my first ebooks was helping people do what I had already done, which was to leave their 9-to-5 job with digital products. So when I first started getting on social media, I was an introvert. I was also scared like you guys, but I still conquered that fear and I put out content on social media. But I wanted to give you some ideas and examples of putting out content based off your journey and your experience. So here you go. Listen, are you tired of renting? This was one of my first videos. Want to make 6 figures with your small business? If I was starting over as a small business owner, get your digital products off Etsy. This is me learning that Etsy was basically ripping me off. So I started to get hip to that and figured out, yo, I got to just put my digital products on my own platforms. But this is just me sharing my journey with just me sitting at the sofa, just talking about nothing big, nothing fancy, you guys. How to sell digital products. Learn how you can quit your 9-to-5 job. Here's my secret to selling ebooks. Need help setting up your funnel. This is when I was getting my products off of platforms like Etsy and starting to sell them on my own platform and get my own domain. Learn how you can quit your 9-to-5 to the future millionaires. All this stuff was just all based off my journey. Once I got even more comfortable on social media, I started going live on TikTok. Now, mind you, as I'm putting out this content in real time, while I'm creating my ebook, people are engaging with me on my social media platform. They're leaving comments. They're asking me questions. They're actually even giving me ideas to add more stuff into the ebook that I didn't even think about, or there were some repetitive questions that I added and answered into the ebook. But one of the most important questions that I was being asked while I'm building my social media and while I'm connecting with my audience and while I'm creating the actual ebook was exactly, how can I achieve what you achieve? And when they would ask me that, that's when I would say, sure, you can learn exactly how I did this step by step, get my ebook. Or if it wasn't created, I would say, stay tuned, join my group, join my community. I'm launching an ebook and you'll be able to have direct access to it when I launch it inside my community. But just to make sure you guys understand, all this came from me just creating content on social media based off my experiences, based off what I learned, telling my journey on social media. Now, the next step after that, or while you're doing that, is to create the actual ebook. And I'm going to show you how to do that in a second. But once you've created the ebook, you want to actually have a link for those people to go purchase it on all of your content. So in the beginning, I was using a platform like TikTok. Now, the downside of TikTok is you can't put a link inside of your bio until you have 1,000 followers. But I was still getting people in my community, or I would refer them to another platform like Instagram to where they could go and download it. A second thing you can do if you're using a platform like TikTok, you can actually put the link in your videos as a text overlay. The easiest and best way for me, you guys, is YouTube. So if you're going to use YouTube, YouTube automatically gives you a YouTube description, and you can put your links there in any of your videos, even if you're just starting out and you have 0 subscribers. But my point is, you want to put your link for those viewers and your audience to buy in all of your content. Now, the last step before I start showing you how to actually create an ebook is you want to go live. Going live, especially after you've been creating and connecting with your audience, is the best way to start promoting your digital product. Now, since then, I've taken a lot of my lives from TikTok and repurpose them to YouTube, but you could still see where I was going live consistently as much as I could on that platform for hours and hours and hours and hours. And I just wanted to show you guys that I'm not just talking this and telling you guys to do something that I haven't done myself. It's a great way to start getting the word out faster and to engage with your people and engage with your audience and start spreading the word about your ebook once you finally finish it. Now, I want you to understand one of the main reasons that you're going live is to do a Q&A because you're already teaching and educating everybody in your content. So you want to answer their questions when you go live. Now, when you go live, be kind of strategic. Don't be all over the place and don't be broad. Pick a title or a subject or a piece of something to talk about that's within your ebook and make that the title of your live and only answer questions pertaining to that. Now, the next step is to actually create the ebook. And this part is very, very simple. Now, when you're creating this ebook, don't worry about silly or crazy things like how many pages should I have? What colors, what font should they be? None of that stuff don't matter. When I tell you guys my first ebook, when I look at it today, it looks horrible as far as the graphics and the fonts. I was all over the place. I wasn't trying to brand, but the information in that ebook, when I tell you those people were reaching out to me and telling me that, man, I learned so much. Thank you, Ronnie. I got a lot of reviews and good testimonials from that ebook because when the people read my ebook, they learned what they paid to learn. The content in my ebook outweighed all the flaws and aesthetics of the ebook itself. So if you're going to be worrying about anything that entails creating a digital product or an ebook, the only thing you need to worry about is making sure that you're delivering the promise and teaching the people what they signed up and gave you their hard-earned money to learn. Now, when you're starting to create your ebook, I'm going to make it very, very simple. But the first thing you want to do is what I highly suggest everybody starting out, whatever you're teaching in your ebook, break it down in steps. And when people see things in steps, it makes whatever you're teaching seem a whole lot more simple. The less steps, the better. But if it's a large amount of steps, don't worry about it. Long as there's numbers and a step-by-step guide, it's better than a whole bunch of jumbled up information. So break whatever you're teaching down in steps. Now, right now, I'm just right here on Google Gemini. If you're not good with this, you can use ChatGPT or any AI software to help you do this. But this is going to be the foundation of your ebook. And all I'm doing is I'm taking this information and I'm transferring it into Canva, which we're going to use to create your ebook in a second. I'm taking this information and I transfer it into Canva. Now, the previous part right here is an outline, but once you have your outline with some bullet points, all you have to do is now just add on and elaborate to them. For example, I just picked number 6, edit and revise. And this is talking about how to create an ebook in 7 steps. So I said, break down and elaborate on number 6 and explain in 4 to 6 paragraphs. And it's polishing your prose right here. And it breaks it down and it breaks it down even further. And you can keep going for as long as you want with this, but you want to do it for each part. And as you're receiving this information, we're just taking it and putting it into our ebook. From there, we're going to do this in Canva. Canva is your best friend. Canva has a lot of templates that you can use to get you started. So if you're not tech savvy, if you're not very good at graphics and aesthetics on doing that part of it, all you have to do is just use their templates and milk the templates dry until you learn how to do it yourself. But all you have to do is just go over here to something like templates. It's going to bring this up. So you can put in something like food recipes and then click on healthy food recipes. And it's going to show you all those templates to get you started with your ebook. Now, once you pick your template, you can come in and start tweaking it to your liking and what makes sense to you and your audience and the subject matter of what you're teaching in that ebook. You can just click on anything and highlight it, change the wording, change the fonts. Don't waste your lot of time trying to be perfect. I've learned through my experience, I'm the only one who really cares about that stuff. The people are only coming for the sauce. They're coming for the meat. They're coming for the information. So don't waste your time on irrelevant stuff. Pick something, put all your information in it so we can make some money from it. Now, a few things I do want to say that you do want to add into your ebook. If you didn't know, you want to actually have a table of contents. That's going to help people sift through your ebook and come back to it and reference things a whole lot faster. And I highly recommend that you have a cover photo for your ebook that could be something that you can use when you're promoting it online, and it will have a good first impression after the people purchase it. Now, as promised, I told you I'd show you my ebook that helped make me my first four figures, five figures, and makes consistent six figures every single year. And it was called The Affiliate Income Network System, which was half of another ebook called The 7 Steps to Quit Your Job This Year. Now, as you can see, my cover was very simple, very clean. I didn't put a lot of effort into it and spend a lot of time trying to make it perfect. But one thing is, I had the table of contents, and this is all a template, you guys. Only thing I did was just put a cool picture in the background and some elements. Another cool thing you would probably want to add in your ebook is a welcome. Let people know who you are, what to expect from this ebook, and actually thanking them for making a purchase. But the most biggest thing that helped me make a lot of money from this ebook, you guys, was me spreading and putting my affiliate links in this product. All you have to do is hyperlink text or images in this ebook, and when the people purchase it and download it and they're viewing it, they can click it and it will redirect them to other products or services that I might have in my business. And this is very simple to do, you guys. All you got to do is just click this, and when it pops up, you'll see something like this pop up, and you just add your link in here, enter a link or search into your link, and then you're going to press enter and then done. Now, if you really want to see what this ebook looks like, it is still available for purchase. You can go to raidtheinternet.com or just click on the first link down below this YouTube video. Now, two final things you want to have in your actual ebook when you're creating it is you want to have a call to action, and you want to also have a place where your audience can connect with you further. Like I said, I've mentioned things like communities and Facebook groups to where people can join and interact with me offline in another platform, and my call to action. Once they purchase my ebook, this tells me right here that these people are action takers. They are ready to buy. They understand that in order for them to be successful, they should be open to investing in their own knowledge, in their own skill set. So of course, they purchase a digital product from me. I upsell them with other products that I have that will enhance them on their journey to success. The point that I'm trying to make, don't limit yourself to only digital products, and especially one digital product or service. Yes, we all got to start somewhere, and you can always come back and add these things later into your ebook if you don't have them all in the beginning. But people are always wanting to learn more, so you want to make sure they have access to more information, which is why I said in the beginning that ebook was one half, but it was the only ebook in the beginning. That ebook spawned another ebook where I talked how I left my job and made six figures on how they could do it too. So that became a separate ebook. And then I started doing coaching, and then people could do one-on-one calls with me. And then I have monthly memberships. A lot of things, a lot of products and services came from just that ebook that I later added on during my own journey in the beginning. Now, the last and final step that you need to do after you've done everything that we discussed prior to this point is you need a place for them to actually go and make the purchase, to take out their credit cards, put in their credit card information, click buy, so that you make money from these digital products. Now, the first thing you want to do is make sure that you have made your ebook accessible. So if you're using a platform like Canva, there's two ways. You can sell it as a PDF. So when you download it, just download the ebook as a PDF and make sure that you download it so that all your links work. And when people click on those links, they'll be redirected to the appropriate websites. Or in Canva, they have something called a view only. With the view only, the people don't need a Canva account to come and look at the ebook, and all your links still work there as well. But in short, they won't have to download it. They click the link and it's kind of like a website, but built within Canva, and it can go and view your ebook at any time they want without downloading. Now, in order to accept payments for your digital products, you're going to need an actual payment gateway, something like PayPal and also Stripe. And you can have your own website and or funnel. I prefer to use funnels, but when I first started out, before I learned about funnels, I was actually using their website. But there's where you can upload your digital product and whatever tool or software that you're using that hosts your website or your funnel, they will make sure all the transactions are taken care of to where the funds are delivered into your bank of choice, and they will automatically deliver the digital product to the actual customer. Pick one that makes sense and works for you based off your knowledge and your skill set, and keep the ball moving so that you can start making money as quickly as possible online. Now, here's an example of my first funnel that I did when I was promoting this ebook. Like I said, you can start here. I like funnels because it actually walks the customer down the buyer's process, but you're welcome to use a website. I just like funnels because they're a little bit easier. Funnels were created to help you sell that one thing. And then after you have acquired the customer, then you can upsell them on other things if you have other products. But if you only have one product right now, then it's probably cool if you just start off with a basic one-page website. Just make sure that it's super clean. The people aren't confused when they land there, and make sure that your button is very visible. And when they click it, it takes them to the place to make their purchase. They see the price and everything's explained in detail. Now, guys, I want you to understand that this is the exact process, the exact step-by-step tutorial I just gave you on how with just one ebook, I was able to turn that into a seven-figure business. I went from $100 a day to $1,000 a month to $5,000 to $10,000 to $20,000 to $100K in a year to over $3 million. Now, this took a time, and this happened over the course of 6 to 7 years, but this is how powerful this method can be if you follow these exact steps on how to create, sell, and market your first ebook or digital product. So my point to you is this: if you take this serious, you can follow the exact same steps that I did and achieve the same results. But definitely make a major commitment to yourself. It's not going to happen overnight. Don't give up when the numbers are there. Don't give up when life starts to happen and you get discouraged. Don't give up when nobody is supporting you. Don't give up when nobody shows up to your lives. You got to keep going. The best advice I can give you is fall in love with the process, not in love with your desired outcome. Fall in love with the journey. Fall in love with teaching. Fall in love with learning. Fall in love with making mistakes and failure. Fall in love with learning from those mistakes and failures. Don't give up on yourself. It's definitely worth it. If I did it, you can do it too. Now, if you're somewhere in the middle of everything I just taught, for example, maybe you have the ebook created and you want to know how to get traffic, or maybe you need to know how to build a website or a funnel, or maybe you need more details on how to create your ebook. I have some more videos that tell you step by step on how to do a variety of those things in more detail. And those links are going to be down below this YouTube video. And finally, if you like this content and you want to learn more about it, I spoke about some stuff that you're highly interested in and you want to learn more about this so you can start your own journey, make sure you give me a like, leave me a comment, tell me what business that you want to start, tell me your big idea, tell me your passion, tell me the title or the subject of your ebook down in the comments below, and most importantly, make sure you give me a big fat subscribe. I'm excited for you and your journey, and I can't wait to see you turn your passion, your knowledge, and your own personal skills into profit. That's going to be my time, you guys. Stay blessed, and I'll see you on the other side of success.